guys, so I want to make a quick video on how to treat scars. So I know a lot of you have a lot of questions on how to incorporate the blading, which is also instrument assisted soft tissue mobilization, but a lot of you know it as blading, how to incorporate the taping, how do I incorporate my fasciablasters into my scar tissue routine and, you know, remodeling and rehabilitation. So I'm going to give you an example of a scar. So I'm going to use Kurt's leg. Kurt was in an accident about, how long ago would you say you were in a car accident? 17 years ago. And so until this day, he kind of still feels the after effects of the car accident because of the scar tissue that had developed over time, and even, you know, discrepancies and compensations that he's been adjusting to over time. So I'm going to show you guys exactly how I treat his scarring, and he does add fasciablasting into his routine. He is strength training now, and he's doing the stretching as well. He's not really, really flexible, but I always tell him to stretch because it's very important, and fascia loves to stretch, fascia loves to lengthen, and fascia loves a challenge. So I am going to teach you how to treat your scars. So I'm going to turn the camera around so you guys can take a look at how I treat the scars on his leg. And basically, you can also treat the scarring the same way as in a C-section. I know some women lose sensations and along the scar, but doing these treatments will help reduce the fibrotic tissue along the scars, bringing a little bit more sensation into the area over time. So I'm going to go ahead and teach you guys how to treat the scars. Okay, so as you can see, he had bruising at one point. It's now healing. He's got a little bit of a yellowing going on there. So he has scars, and if you can see the one by his knee as well. So he has a scar right here and another one. You can even still see, you know, where they put the stitches. So he has them along here. So this one's about this big and this one's about this big. And he does have another one a little bit up in the upper thigh area. You guys do see I did cup him a couple of days ago because his he wasn't doing so hot the other day. So I'm going to get started. So I'm gonna teach you how to do the blading first. So I have an old stainless steel guasha tool I used to use. I'm gonna show you an example here with the polycarbonate rock tape blades that I have. Is another one, the stainless steel rock tape blade. I can teach you how to use that, this one, as well as this one. This is a little bit more heavier, has a little bit more weight to it. And then we can show you how to use the Mohawk a little bit. But most important is to figure out exactly where all the scar tissue is. So if you have a guasha tool, I'm gonna go ahead and teach you exactly. So we're gonna lubricate this area very nicely. I'm also gonna lubricate that scar up there as well, very nicely. That's that. Just a little bit, goes a long way. So I'm gonna first scan. So this feels pretty tough to me right here. So this is exactly where the IT band runs. So we don't really want to jam up the IT band too deep. We want to do very light in this area. The IT band is meant to be taut, so you don't want to be digging into the IT band. It's just really tight, taut band. That's the way it's supposed to be. But we're going to go very lightly over it. So I do feel some Rice Krispies, that's how we like to call them, Rice Krispies, around this area here. So we want to be able to remodel this tissue up here because it's still going to compromise, especially the knee joint here. So scar tissue, to me, it's like a domino effect. It has domino effect to the body. So if there's an issue here, over time, it's gonna start making itself, you know, making its way into the neighboring tissues. So we wanna bring in movement. We wanna bring in manipulation of the soft tissue to get that blood flowing in here and get those cells to reorganize and remodel this tissue. All right, so we're just gonna gently go right into the thigh here. So this actually feels a lot better than it felt the other day. He still has some stuff going on here. How does that feel to you, Kurt?
Sore?
Okay, so he still feels a little bit sore. So we're just gonna go very light in this area. All right, so this is what we're doing here. We're doing a little bit of blading, also known as instrument-assisted soft tissue mobilization. Gua sha is a little bit more intense, but we're not going to do that today because he is feeling sore. Now I'm just gonna show you how to use the mullet here. This is made out of plastic polycarbonate. Same thing that that our cups are made out of, the polycarbonate plastic. So same concept here. This is exactly how we are blading here. We use the other side as well. So yeah, this definitely feels a lot smoother to me than it did the other day. And then we're gonna come up here to the knee. Okay, so we're basically just kind of scanning. I'm scanning. So here feels a little tight. I'm gonna use my fascia blasters to work this area deeper in more detail. So I'm just gonna show you how to use the stainless steel mullet. Here we go, right into this area. It feels a little bit tight here too, to me. So these blades are almost like, we've compared them in the past to basset hounds. They're just, we use them just to kind of find the soft tissue discrepancies. I feel some tightness here too as well. Not so much here, this feels actually good to me, but right around the scar tissue, right here, it feels tight. Okay, and the same thing, we're gonna do the same thing with the mallet. So you guys get the idea of we're just kind of searching for those tissue, soft tissue discrepancies. So I can, so they point to me to the right direction on how to go about treating the tissue and where's my main focus. And then last but not least, the mohawk. And the mohawk is really cool because it's got this little fin that I can actually work in detail if I wanted to just use the instrument to do the, to actually treat this area, right? But because we're just scanning, we're just gonna use the other side. So it's feeling smooth like butter. For sure, this feels a lot better than it did the other day. We gave him a nice full body blast, literally from head to toe. I used my Pro Blaster on his head. So full body blasts are an absolute must because the body works as a whole. So I'm going to take, now if you're very sensitive to the scar, if your scar is very sensitive to begin with, or you have no sensation at all, I actually like to use my OMG tool to start invigorating the area and bring some blood flow to it, just to you know, invigorate, add some excitement into those cells in that area. Okay, but if you're also extremely sensitive, you can also use the invigorating tool on your scar just to stimulate the blood flow into that area, get that tissue prepped for more detailed treatment, just like that. And so as you can see, the area is getting flushed. Depending how deep your tissue, your scar tissue is, sometimes you will not see that flush look right away. Going to take some time depending on how
really constricted and how fibrotic that tissue is. But over time, the more you treat your scar, you will see a huge change in the integrity of the skin. You're gonna start seeing a diminishing of the scar itself. You're gonna see remodeling happening, taking place. The integrity of the skin is gonna feel a lot softer, smoother, pliable. It's just amazing how our bodies remodel themselves. It's just crazy. Okay, so as you see, it's nice and flush. Now we're going to take it to the other scar. And again, you want to check on your pressure. If this is too much for you, lighten up the pressure a little bit, go a little softer. Okay, harder is not always better. You can go side to side if you want, change it up, or you can go up and down. Just like that. And side to side. Just like that. Okay, so you can see we're getting some reaction here. We're getting a nice red flush look. Okay, now we can change our tool. And I like to use, you could either use the OMG tool or the face blaster. I'm gonna go right up to the scar right up here. And then I'm just gonna gently stimulate this area with the one claw tool, just like that. You can also use your other hand if you need to, kind of stretch the tissue, move it around, mobilize it. Just like that. And remember, the key here is to get that blood flowing in this area, because that's what we need. We need this to go through the inflammation process, because that's what we're doing. We are initiating the body's natural inflammation process, where it goes through the stages of inflammation, proliferation, and remodeling and maturation. So during the inflammation phase is when exactly what's happening here. We are stimulating blood. We are stimulating heat. Okay. And that is what signals the body to call upon the healing cells. All right. Your cells that come and clean stuff up. And that's what they take. They take away all the yucky stuff that doesn't serve us in our scars, in our tissues. And then it goes into the remodeling phase, or I should say the proliferation, where it starts to create new tissue, and then into the remodeling, where it starts laying down the collagen and all that good stuff. So that's exactly what we're looking for. Go right into that scar. And that's where we're looking for. We're looking for that red, nice flush look. Beautiful. So that's what we're looking for. Okay, and then we can move on to the next scar here. And again, pull, pull. Now I'm just doing a detail, some detail work here. And then of course I would treat the entire extremity to just kind of like flush everything out, just to invigorate the neighboring tissues. And we're just gonna work this area in detail, and then we can treat the entire leg, just to invigorate the neighboring tissues. All right, so we're looking to do the same thing here. Get that blood flowing, prep the tissue, get the blood going. And pay attention to your pressure. You can go deep if you want, if you can tolerate it, or you can just go a little lighter. Okay, just like that. So this is a really old scar. If you have a fresh scar, I would totally first get the clearance of your physician. But usually I think it's after, I believe it's 2 weeks. After 2 weeks, usually they do give the clearance to start the rehabilitation therapy. Okay, but always get the clearance from your physician if you have a fresh scar to make sure it's clear from infection and it's healing beautifully. So definitely that's one thing you have to make sure. Okay. And you should definitely bring your blasters to your therapist. Some of us are very open to working with tools. So definitely bring your tools in, you know, ask your therapist if she can use them in your post-operative rehab. Okay. So if you want, you can also use your face blaster here. If you can tolerate it, you can definitely use the face blaster here. Do some cross fiber with the face blaster. Okay, and then I'm gonna go up here too as well. So this is where I felt a lot of the Rice Krispies in this area. He's a little tender here because he just pulled away. So that means let me lighten up my pressure. So definitely this is where I felt the Rice Krispies, right along this line here. Okay. Just like that. So we're getting a nice reaction here. Nice little red. I see the flush, the pink. I think I see it so well through the camera, but I actually could see it here, plain sight. That is nice and pink. And that's exactly what we're looking for. Okay. So then we can move on by you can even use your Pro Blaster too. Let me not forget to demonstrate the Pro Blaster here. The Pro Blaster is awesome. It's very gentle. It gives you 3 more claws than the face blaster. A total of 6 small prep claws. So we always want to prep with the small claws. And then because the small claws are excellent to prepare your receptors for a deeper treatment with the larger claws. So this is a perfect way to prepare your tissue. You can also incorporate fascia pulling, right? Fascia pulling. I'll show you how to use your cups to do fascia pulling. So he is constricted here. You could tell I can't even pick up the tissue. Just a little bit here, a little bit here, a little bit here, but not here. This is exactly where I feel the tightness along his leg. So we have work to do for sure. So this is the Pro Blaster, guys. Okay. All right, nice pink look. And then after that, we can use our Mini 2, which I love, my favorite, best of both worlds, right? With the nugget and then the large claws for a deeper massage. So I'm just going super light here because I know he's super sensitive. I'm gonna use 1 claw of the Mini 2. You can also use the Mini 1 if you prefer as well. If you want to go light, you can use the Mini 1, but I like using the Mini 2. And if I need both claws, I can always shift from 1 to 2 claws. Okay, so just like that. Getting into that scar. So there. And then we work into that scar too, by the knee. And this is gonna take time. It's gonna take time. Our bodies are just, it took time for them to develop these scars. It took time, you know, for this tissue to get hard like this, so it's gonna take time for it to get softer. And I promise you it will. It's going to get softer, it's gonna get better, it's gonna get pliable, and you're gonna feel better. Okay, just stay consistent and you will see the difference over time. Okay, just stay focused. Okay, and then of course we can shift over to using the nugget. So I'm gonna switch the heads to the OMG nugget. Now I like this nugget too because it's pretty small and I can work in detail. So if I wanted to work on that scar here with my nugget, I can do so, pull the skin a little bit and kind of work in that area. So, okay, you can also work over the scar at this point because this is an old scar. New scars, you just gotta be careful. Okay, use your due diligence when working with fresh scars. Okay, usually with fresh scars, if I had a post-operative client, I work, you know, far from it. I work not over the scar, but next to the scar, just to kind of bring blood flow into that scar, right? When it's a fresh scar, you kind of want to work and get that. But this is an old scar, so with the old scar, I could totally work over it. This is using the OMG nugget, just like that. How does that feel to you, Kurt?
Not bad?
I used to treat my sister's C-section scar, and when I was doing this to her, she said she couldn't feel it. So yes, for C-sections, it is completely normal that you lose sensation because obviously we are going to have a disruption of the receptors in this area, the sensory receptors. I also had a client who had a reduction of her breasts as well. Same concept. She felt she couldn't really feel, my blasting or my nuggeting. She couldn't feel it. But over time, it started to, the sensations started coming back, which was pretty awesome. It just shows you how resilient our bodies are. And when with the proper tools, you can totally help the body heal. So as you can see, it's getting nice and red. The blood flow is getting into that scar. This is awesome. And you can use your fingers to kind of spread that skin apart to get that blood right in there. And then do a little bit of fascia pulling, right? So we're gonna go to the scar that is above his knee here a little bit and work on that scar right here. You can see it, it's right there. So we're gonna, this hurts him a little bit. He's pulling away from me a little bit. So I'm just gonna get a little lighter. I'm just gonna go a little lighter, not too much. Okay, just like that. And I'm going next to the scar, above it, right? And then below it. And then on top of it. Just like that, and then add a little bit of fascia pulling here in this area. Okay, and I'm also gonna teach you how to cup these scars, okay? Just to, if you want to prep the tissue before you blade with a little bit of, you can do the cupping after the blading because you kinda wanna use the blading to see where you wanna work. Right? So we can do the cupping after the bleeding because now you know exactly where the sticky tissue is. So we are going to use one of Ashley's cups. If you guys have the Ashley cupping set, I'm going to show you exactly how to cup. This is one of her small cups. So we're going to kind of do a little bit of pumping here with the cups. Pump, 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 like you would do a fascia pull, right? Just pay attention to your pressure. There you go, you see? Nice blood flow there. And again, pump, 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 pump. So you can cup before and you can cup after. If you want to flush using your cups, you can do so, right? So it feels nice, a little bit more pliable than it was before. Remember, I couldn't even pick this up, and now I kind of can get a little bit of lift. All right, and then we're gonna go to that scar up there. Here you go, pump, pump, there we go. And just pull, twist, pull, you can pull. And then we can twist, use a little bit of twisting motion, right? To get those fibers to manipulate and move and mobilize. Just like that, get those tissues to glide. There you go. And if you guys have, if you guys don't have the Ashley set, you can always get like a AccuZone set. Check out my store and you can get the AccuZone set. They're just as good. And pump and twist, pump and twist and twist and pull. Okay, again, this is an old scar, so he can tolerate me pulling on it this way. But if it's a new scar, just be gentle. There we go, get that blood flow, just like that. Okay, just like that. That feels amazing, so much better. Here we go, we're gonna use the cup here. Okay, twist, tug, just like that. Or if you want to leave them static, that's fine too. Now what I mean as static is means leaving them in one position. Okay, twist, tug, okay, and release. All right, guys, so if you guys want to add a little bit of vibration to that scar, you can do so. You can actually just use a vibrational tool. So this is a nice vibrational tool made by Trigger Point. You can find this guy on my Amazon store. All right, you can go on to jacklmt.com, or you can go right directly onto my link tree on my Instagram and just search for my Amazon store, and you will find this beautiful tool under my massage tools. And you can just add a little bit of vibration onto that scar to help it heal. It's just like that. Just like that. We're feeding the connective tissue awesome feedback to help it heal. Okay, and the same thing to this scar right here. Little bit of vibration. Giving it nice, gentle vibrations, right, to help it heal. Just like that. Or if you want to get fancy schmancy, you can add a rock pod. These rock pods, you can find them at my Amazon store as well. And then you can just add them directly to the scar, just like that. Bring some blood flow, change the feedback, and just vibrate the tip of the rock pod. So every little thing that you do adds up, and it's all positive feedback to the body, so you can help it heal. Just like that. And I'm actually just vibrating the tip of the ball of the rock pod, just like that. How does that feel, Kurt? Feels good? Mm-hmm. Awesome. So very good. So we're getting positive feedback from our patient, and we will be getting positive feedback from our connective tissue with time. Okay? And then you just remove the pod, just like that. And look at all that awesome blood flow we're getting there. That is amazing. And then we can use the same tool to flush. We always want to flush upwards towards the lymphatic lymph nodes here in the inguinal area, okay? So we always want to do a nice lymphatic clearing before we start any kind of body work to prep those lymph nodes for the work that is about to come. And then you can flush one more time at the end of the treatment. So this is where you can either flush manually, or you can use your cups to flush towards the lymph nodes. Just like that. Just like that, going up into the inguinal lymph nodes. All right, you guys, I hope you guys enjoyed that video. I hope it was super helpful on how to approach and how to treat our scars with all these amazing tools that we have to provide us with the healing, with the blood flow, and the remodeling of our tissue. If you guys have any questions on where to get them, how to use them, please leave them in the comments below. Thank you so much and have a blessed day. Bye.